Cardboard fiber kit,
FitmentIndustries.com. Low price of $9,999.99. What is going on, guys? Jels from Fitment Industries. We're back with another episode of The Build Sheet. Now, today we are going to be going over a topic that has been around for quite some time. It's been in and out of the car scene, and from what we've seen recently, it's kind of starting to make a comeback in the like starts of like aero pieces and things like that. On today's episode of The Build Sheet, we're going to be talking about carbon fiber. Carbon Ferber. And before we go ahead and get into it, don't forget to subscribe, hit the bell notification so you get notified when we upload next, and let's just jump right into it. So as early as the 1800s, right around the time when our friend Thomas Edison was working on the light bulb, carbon fiber filaments were being used for experiments. Produced by baking cotton threads at a high temperature, the cotton would begin to carbonize and eventually become an all carbon fiber filament. Little did we know at the time that this process would become one of the most widely used processes in the world of composites that we know today. It wouldn't be until quite a few years later, in the year 1958, that a gentleman by the name of Roger Bacon created some of the first high-performance carbon fibers right here in the United States. Cleveland, Ohio, to be exact, at the Union Carbide Parma Technical Center. Instead of using strands of cotton, Bacon found that applying a similar heating process to the manufactured fiber known as rayon, they could achieve much better results. Now, of course, there was still a lot to learn, and after a few years of tweaking the process of creating the carbon fibers, in the year 1960, the first high-content carbon fiber with a carbon content of 99% was developed by Richard Millington of H.I. Thompson Fiberglass Company. Compared to the first trials of producing carbon fibers from rayon that contain around 20% carbon, the high carbon content fibers showed a combination of high amount of elasticity and tensile strength. Now, of course, to produce the carbon fiber stuff that we know today, those strands are woven into sheets, which are then cut and then sent out, which are applied with epoxy resin to mold and form the parts that we know and love. So throughout the years following, carbon fibers and composites were used mostly in the development of aircraft and their engines, specifically in the development of jet engines and their compressor blades. But the use of carbon fiber and composites were being used and experimented within a variety of aerospace systems, ranging from civilian aircraft all the way up to, well, spaceships. Not spaceships, but rockets. Same thing. Carbon fiber is a very strong and lightweight material, hence the reason why it got its start in aerospace development. However, as time went on, we started to see it sneak its way into the automotive scene. With carbon fiber being 5 times as strong as steel and lighter than aluminum, it comes as no surprise as to why high-end auto manufacturers started to use this material in the production of their cars. With the first ever production car to implement what is known as the carbon fiber monocoque cell design was none other than the Bugatti EB110, which was produced right away in the early 1990s. You know the car, it's the one that the 300ZX stole its headlights from. And it didn't take long for the designers of McLaren to pick up on this and implement it 1 year later in 1992 with the McLaren F1. From there on, the use of carbon fiber in the automotive industry blew up. And now today we see it almost everywhere, especially in the aftermarket scene. You have companies such as Sabon and Carbon Creations that produce everything from carbon fiber hoods to bumpers to side skirts, fenders, doors, spoilers, you name it. If you've been shopping around for anything of your car lately, you've more than likely seen carbon fiber options from pretty much anything and everything for your car. However, the aftermarket companies weren't the only ones to take advantage of the benefits of carbon fiber. Of course, high-end auto manufacturers such as Bugatti and McLaren continue to use carbon fiber and composites in the development of their cars. But however, they aren't the only ones. You have examples of other manufacturers such as Chevy with the removable carbon roof in their Corvettes as well. And it's Ford who introduced their 2016 GT350, rocking a full set of carbon fiber wheels right off the assembly line. But why is this? Why is carbon fiber such an important material when it comes to the automotive industry, or just an important material in general? What are the benefits of having carbon fiber parts on your car? Well, besides the fact of it looking awesome and making sure that you hit the necessary rating in Need for Speed Underground 2 so you can get on the final magazine cover, carbon fiber does offer quite a few more benefits than that. with the number one fact that it is very lightweight, like we mentioned. If you're looking to shave a few pounds off of your car's total weight, carbon fiber replacements are a great way to go. Like I mentioned before, you can find almost anything as a carbon replacement for your car. We have seen it quite a few times throughout the last few years where cars will pop up every now and then at shows that are almost entirely made up of carbon fiber from bumper to bumper. This paired with the fact that it's about 4 to 5 times stronger than steel gives carbon fiber an amazing strength to weight ratio. Now, obviously when it comes to performance driving, weight means a lot. And if there's a material out there that can not only perform as well as steel or aluminum, but perform better, and all the while maintaining a fraction of the weight, it's kind of hard to argue with it. Manufactured similar to the way fiberglass parts are, carbon fiber pieces can be molded into just about any shape that you could desire. This is why we see a lot of aftermarket hoods with cool vents and fenders that offer more aggressive body lines and all those things like that that you normally wouldn't see with a sheet metal part or anything else. Style and performance are huge gains with carbon fiber car parts, as well as its resistance to corrosion, but it does come at a cost, and that being probably one of the biggest downsides to carbon fiber. It's not cheap. Now, although the price has come down tremendously over the past few years, you are still going to be spending a pretty penny on carbon fiber options. You can expect to spend right around $800 to $1,000 for a decent carbon fiber hood, and even more when you start getting into things such as door panels or door shells and even wide body kits that people are coming out with nowadays. Now, the sole reason for this being is the manufacturing process itself. The material is expensive to produce, and when it comes down to taking that material and turning it into something that you can put on your car, the prices soon begin to add up with labor costs, with the cost of the mold, with the time that it takes to produce all of that stuff. So who knows, maybe a few years down the road, there'll be a new material that proves itself better than carbon fiber, and the price will maybe drop off then. Other downsides that people would argue is that you have to take care of it a little more than your normal material, whether it be the clear coat that is meant to protect it or watching for cracks that may form, may reduce the integrity of the part. Just be careful with it. Make sure it's not, you know, getting hit with anything that would cause like a shatter, cause things to crack, because then you're just not gonna have a good time with it. So the question comes down to, is carbon fiber worth it? Well, it all depends really. If you're building a time attack car, something that every pound counts, then 100% carbon fiber is gonna be a great solution. Especially with wheels, we see more and more carbon fiber options becoming available, whether it be in the barrels, whether it be in the lips. However, when it comes down to more everyday enthusiasts such as you and me, the benefits of carbon fiber really don't seem to matter as much. Like I mentioned, carbon fiber is a fantastic aesthetic styling choice and can really make a car stand out. So go ahead and let us know your thoughts on carbon fiber down in the comments below. I'm Jealous from Fitment Industries. Don't forget wheels, tires, and suspension, fitmentindustries.com. And if you're over there, don't be afraid to add your car to the gallery, fitmentindustries.com/add. We'd like to see your aftermarket car, help out some people, help out us, help out other people find about Fitment. I'm Jealous from Fitment Industries. We'll see you later. Peace.